let's take a look at the demo code that I was talking about for a config file. This demo code is available as part of the lab files that you download for this course. Just look in the demo folder in the collateral that you downloaded. In that folder, you have a config example, a config.ini, a local, and a remote. The config example, let me show you this one, is really very simple. You're importing the config parser. This is part of Python. It's part of the basic install of Python, so it's nothing special. I'm doing an allow no value true. I'll talk a little bit more about that in just a second. And then we're reading the config.ini file, which is right here in this same directory. From this, I'm creating a client. I'm doing a config get for the endpoint, the access key, secret key, any session token if there is one. I am doing my security there as well, and I am also getting a region if I have one. Now, I don't have to fill in all of those values, just the ones that I need. And what I'm then doing is I'm just getting a list of buckets that's available on whatever server I've connected to. So if I show you the config.ini file, this is connecting to localhost with my dev user, dev password. There's no session token. My security is set to false. Okay. And if I run this with Python 3, what I get back out is this dev location. So that's the dev bucket that I just created in the last session. So obviously it's got a pretty recent creation date there. Now, if I want to change this up a little bit, I have a remote IMI, and this one goes out to play.minio. I'm not dealing with any regions. There's still no session token, but notice my secure is now true, but I don't actually have to change anything. I'm just going to copy this remote ini to my config ini, and I'm going to rerun the code just like this. And when I do that, I get a list of the buckets that are available out on our play.minio. There's tons of them. That's because this is a publicly accessible server. Anybody who just wants to log in and see what you can do on the console, you can log in and play around with it a little bit there. All of this data, by the way, gets collected on a regular basis, but there's tons and tons and tons and tons and tons of buckets out there that folks have been working with. And I didn't have to change a line of code. It just was literally just changing the ini file, and I'm good to go. So that demo, this is really the end of this particular lesson. So let me go back and we'll do a little checkpoint.